विटामिन बी थ्री। नेम ऑफ विटामिन बी थ्री इज निकोटिनिक एसिड, निकोटिनिक एसिड। इज इट इज ट्रू विटामिन? नो, इट इज नॉट अ ट्रू विटामिन, बिकॉज विटामिन इज द सब्सटेंस विच वी टेक फ्रॉम आउटसाइड, इट नॉट गेट सिंथेसाइज इन साइड द बॉडी, वी आर गेटिंग इट फ्रॉम द फूड आउटसाइड सोर्स, सो इट नॉट अ विटामिन। दैट मीन्स इट मस्ट बी फॉर्म इन साइड द बॉडी, एंड विटामिन बी थ्री इज फॉर्म फ्रॉम ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एमिनो एसिड दैट इज ट्रिप्टोफान। One important question is that how many gram of tryptophan gives 1 milligram of niacin? Answer is 60 milligram of tryptophan yields 1 milligram of niacin, that is vitamin B3. Now the question is, what are the role of vitamin B3? What are the roles of vitamin B3 in our body? First, it helps in metabolism. It helps in metabolism of carbohydrate, proteins and fats. Second, it maintains the integrity. It maintains the integrity of three systems in our body: nervous system, a skin, and intestine. If you use the term nicotine, you easily derived it from this for nervous system. This is for cutaneous, that is a skin, and this is for intestine. As you know, it comes under vitamin B complex group, that is vitamin B3 is water soluble vitamin. But in spite of water soluble vitamin, it does not excreted in urine. It is water soluble vitamin but does not get excreted in urine. What are the metabolite of this nicotinic acid? It's two metabolites. First is N-methyl nicotinamide and second one is N-methyl pyridone. These are the two metabolites of nicotine, that is vitamin B3. Now the question is active form or vitamin B3 acts as coenzyme form, and this dependent on NAD plus or NADP plus. This depend on two. The NAD plus related enzyme is, that is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide. And this is nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. So NADP related enzyme is first pyruvate dehydrogenase. Second, alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Third, lactate dehydrogenase. Fourth, malate dehydrogenase. Isocitrate dehydrogenase. These comes under NAD plus coenzyme group, and this enzyme you must heard in which cycles of body? Which cycle? That is Krebs cycle. And Krebs cycle is for carbohydrate metabolism. So you can see how this enzyme is helpful in the carbohydrate metabolism. When we learn about the Krebs cycle, we will discuss details. Now NADP plus. It helps in reductive biosynthesis. Reductive biosynthesis of what? Synthesis of cholesterol and steroid. Is any other role of NADP plus? Yes. It acts as free radical scavenger. Also help in formation of DNA. And the last one is one carbon metabolism. What are the enzyme related to NADP plus? This is very important. Number one, HMG-CoA reductase. Second one is enoyl reductase. Third is folate reductase. So these are the enzyme related to NADP plus. Now the interesting part of vitamin B3, that is source of vitamin B3, and this is important with PSM point of view. Good source or rich source? What are the rich source of vitamin B3? Liver, kidney, meat and fish. This is the good source of vitamin B3, that is niacin. What is the poor source? You must know about the poor source, that is milk. Milk is the poor source of vitamin B3. Interesting fact. In some state, that is Telangana. Or Andhra Pradesh. Where most of the people generally eat maize or jowar. What are the scientific name of jowar? Sorghum, bulgur, bulgur. This is the scientific name of jowar. What we find in this, there is high concentration of leucine, and what it does, it inhibit leucine inhibit a rate limiting enzyme of niacin synthesis. And can you guess the name of that enzyme? That is QPR page. Remember, this is not PQR, this is QPR page. And this is the rate limiting enzyme for niacin synthesis. That means tryptophan is not converted to niacin in maize eater or sorghum eater population. This is not going to convert. And what is the condition lead to that deficiency? In early stages, mind it, in early stages, you are not able to find it is a case of vitamin B3 deficiency because of the vague symptom. Patient complains of anorexia. And because of anorexia, there is weight loss. Some patient complains burning sensation. But when the deficiency prolonged, that means in later stage of vitamin B3 deficiency, what will occur? I know you all must heard about the 3D. What is 3D? The first D is diarrhea. And what is 3D? This is related to pellagra. And the classical triad of pellagra is 3D, diarrhea. What diarrhea do? If patient having diarrhea, what is the problem? If diarrhea is long, prolonged or severe, in that cases, there is atrophy of intestinal villi. And this will lead to malabsorption. That means diarrhea ultimately lead to malabsorption. What is the second D of pellagra? It is dermatitis. What are the peculiarity of that dermatitis? This is very peculiar things. And that dermatitis is symmetrical, bilateral, and photosensitive dermatitis. Remember that term, photosensitive dermatitis. What do you mean by this photosensitive dermatitis? That means a skin affected area or face, neck, leg, arm, What is this? This is basically a sun exposed area. This is basically a sun exposed area. So it is photosensitive dermatitis. And if this dermatitis is at neck, the important term used for that dermatitis, that is castle necklace. The term used is castle necklace. What are the third one? Third is dementia. And the last, if it's a severe form of pellagra, that will lead to fourth D, that is patient will die, that is death of the patient. So the next question is, what is the RDA? This is 20 mg per day, but if we consider in the form of energy, the recommended daily allowance is 6.6 mg per 1000 kilocalorie of energy intake. Now the interesting questions comes. Is there is any toxicity of the vitamin B3 that is niacin? Yes, vitamin B3 toxicity is there. And what are the toxicity feature of the vitamin B3? Mind it, this is cutaneous flushing. Other is GIT intolerance. And what will occur in case of a severe form of toxicity? That is, severe form of toxicity will affect one important organ in our body, liver, that is hepatotoxicity. How will confirm the patient is going in the hepatic toxicity? Yes, by seeing the clinical feature, and the clinical features appear in the form of jaundice. But as a doctor, you must stamp that patient having jaundice by investigation. And when you do investigation, you will find there is elevation of enzyme AST and ALT. This will confirm there is toxicity, liver toxicity is there. Now, other conditions associated with pellagra-like syndrome. Other conditions associated with pellagra-like syndrome. First one is heart nerve disease. What occurs in heart nerve disease? There is intestinal malabsorption. And renal reabsorption. Renal reabsorption of tryptophan. So, when tryptophan increase in body, it will produce pellagra-like symptom. Second is carcinoid syndrome. What will occur in carcinoid syndrome? There is increased productions. increase production of serotonin. This will produce pelagra-like symptom. Third one is vitamin B6 deficiency. How vitamin B6 deficiency produces pelagra-like symptom? There is defective kininurinage, and it will lead to defective production of niacin, and it will produce pelagra-like symptom. What are the therapeutic use of niacin? And this is very, very important. Therapeutic use of niacin. It helps in lipid modification. Means it is lipid modifying drug. Lipid modifying drugs. It acts as lipid modifying drugs. What are the effect? Remember, it increases HDL level in plasma. It increases the HDL level in plasma, that is beneficial for body. And it decreases triglyceride level, and it decreases LDL level in plasma. So, it is also beneficial for the body. So, this is the therapeutic use of niacin. That is, it increases the LDL level in plasma and decreases the triglyceride LDL level in plasma. Now, in exam, you may get a question image-based or video-based where you have to pick up which deficiency is there. So, we go to the pictures of this vitamin deficiency. Now, see, this is a classical appearance of Kessel necklace. You can see, you can easily appreciate this Kessel necklace. You can also appreciate here, and this is dermatitis in the exposed area. You can easily appreciate this Kessel necklace. This is dermatitis in the exposed area. So, if you find this type of features, obviously the deficiency is vitamin B3, that is niacin, and the deficiency of niacin lead to pelagra, and this is all about the niacin deficiency. Thank you.